Council of Kyle. Kyle Dupler has returned.
If one is still trying to use government to regulate people, then one is also metaphorically like Truman never leaving. Do you believe the authority of governments, as we know them today, are legitimate? We can be specific to the US Constitution if that's helpful.
Let me show you something. This is a copy of the United States Constitution. And what it says, among other things, is that the Congress shall have power to lay and collect taxes. In other words, a long time ago, a bunch of guys got together and wrote down on a piece of paper, "We have the right to rob you." Now, they didn't call it robbery, they called it taxation, because it sounds nicer. But it's essentially the same thing. We have the right to take your property from you by force if necessary, without your consent. Now, they also wrote a whole lot of rules about how the robbers would be appointed and the legislative rituals which would have to precede the robbery and the different kinds of robbery they'd be allowed to do. But in essence, what this piece of the Constitution says is, we have the right to rob you. And did you believe them? When I did it, when I wrote down on paper that I had the right to rob you, you gave me a funny look. When they did it, did you believe them? Did you accept that this gave them moral permission to take your property without your consent? I bet you did. If you're like 99.999% of the population, you have accepted as unquestionable gospel the notion that this piece of paper gave to some mere mortal human beings the moral right to forcibly confiscate wealth from other people and call it taxation.
It's the people that make the government authoritative, not a piece of paper. If the people disown the government, then the government has no authority.
Which people?
We, the people of the United States. It's not much different from a tribe. Just because someone calls himself the chief, that doesn't automatically make them the leader. The only thing that makes someone a leader is if people actually listen to them and follow them.
Aren't those people all dead already?
As far as I'm aware, the United States Constitution has always meant to be a living document. When we, the people, no longer represents the people who are governed, then the document dies.
Fatality.
The only authority it has is the authority we give it.
Can any person or group delegate an authority it doesn't already have?
Are you asking, if I have no authority, can I give you authority?
I'm asking where we the people gained the power to tax, as listed in Article 1, Section 8 of the U.S. Constitution.
You tell me.
It is made up. I've already taken the position that the authority is not legitimate. Spooner's essay, No Treason, No. 6, addresses rather comprehensively the most common arguments for the Constitution's authority. Those who say the Constitution has authority are making the positive claim, for which the burden of proof is on them to prove it exists. Proving something doesn't exist, a negative claim, cannot be done. The Constitution cannot stand up to the requirement of consent of the governors mentioned in the Declaration of Independence.
That depends on how you define authority. Do you agree that you have the authority to speak for yourself and allow others to speak on your behalf?
Yes, usually with conditions and limitations. I cannot authorize your great-great-great-grandchildren to speak on behalf of my great-great-great-grandchildren, posterity.
Yeah, I agree. It is their authority to give to whom they see fit. For generations, kids in school have recited the Pledge of Allegiance as a means of giving consent or authority to be governed.
Brainwashing by repetition before the age of consent is not consent.
That entirely depends on where you define the age of consent and why.
More importantly, The pledge is not in the Constitution. It was created over a century later. However, for the sake of argument and despite compulsory attendance and coercive funding of schools, call it consent anyway. The pledge does not have a time stipulation. The fact that it's repeated daily could set the expectation that it expires after 24 hours. There's no limitation on ending the allegiance and consent stated in the pledge. Consent can be revoked as easily as it was given.
Any expression of patriotism and/or loyalty to the country is a form of consent. Do you agree that the 1% needs to be regulated?
That's not how consent works. Saying, I like Walmart, or even, I pledge allegiance to shop at Walmart, does not give Walmart consent to force me to buy their products. Both of us have to consent and complete the exchange. No, I don't agree that the 1% need to be regulated. The 99% don't need regulated either.
You don't agree that the FDA is corrupt because of the 1%? I really don't think it's a good idea to let people like Bill Gates and the Monsanto Company run around and do whatever they want.
The FDA is corrupt because it's based on institutionalized coercion and false authority. What Bill Gates and Monsanto can do to people is far more limited without the strong arm of government protecting them and harming competition.
Yeah, I'm not convinced that if it were not for the government, people like Bill Gates wouldn't just establish themselves as dictators. That, or the gang leaders would. I lived in East LA for 2 years. That stuff isn't pretty. That's what the world turns to when people disown the government. Nonetheless, I find myself in a bit of a pickle. I don't trust the government, but I trust the 1% even less, and believe they need to be regulated. So do I go with Blue Team? Oh wait, the 1% is kind of puppeteering Blue Team. It kind of reminds me of that scene from Fievel Goes West, where the cats are using a mouse puppet to try and influence all of the mice to do what they want. It truly is an American tale. And it appears like you can't even get into any of the federal government offices unless you're part of the 1%. I think this meme illustrates our current society a little too well. It doesn't matter which is in the lead, red team or blue team, because in the end, it's the same thing. They're controlled by the same people. Welcome, Kyle Anderson. Thank you for joining us.
If you take away the power of the government, which is currently controlled by the 1%, you hurt both. So win-win.
How is that not letting the 1% run free? Here you go, Monsanto. Go do what you want.
Because they do what they want now.
So how do we regulate the 1% and stop them from doing whatever they want?
Arrest them when they break the law. I am not an anarchist.
Laws are regulation. Do you agree?
Yes. And I am against overregulation. We have too many laws. The reason the 1% owns politicians is because those politicians can write legislation that benefits them and hurts their competition. Should there be regulation? Yes. Should Congress be able to pass tens of thousands of pages worth of it every year? Absolutely not. Take away their ability to pass 3,000-page omnibus bills, require a higher majority to pass bills, give every bill a sunset period where it has to be revoted on. All bills should pertain to one subject. The public and Congress should get months to read the bill before a vote. In order to make any bill permanent, require a public vote.
I absolutely love that. That sounds like a very reasonable solution. Is there a party that embraces that kind of outlook yet? That sounds way more preferable than just letting the 1% have their way with us.
It's a fairly libertarian position, but I don't think the Libertarians' Party fully embraces those exact policies. Most libertarians will, but it's not like the party platform.
It kind of seems like that should be a every party position. That and congressional term limits.
I believe the correct term for my position is minarchy, which is a subset of libertarians.
Are the libertarians pushing for any kind of voting reform? As far as I'm aware, the Green Party is the only one trying to do that. Or at least, that used to be the case. I think a lot of this puppeteering issue can be solved when it is easier for non-one percenters to make it into federal offices.
I am not sure. But being libertarian candidates have a fraction of the support and therefore a fraction of the funds probably.
It always comes down to funds, doesn't it? Well, I think that's some pretty good food for thought. Though I have very little confidence in the current voting system, especially when it comes to the Electoral College, which utterly undermines each individual state's popular vote, I still believe it is super important to state where you stand on the issues. All that is required for evil to prosper is for good men to sit down and do nothing. Thank you for your input. This message has been brought to you by the Flat Earth Institute of Science, with a shout out to our Flat Earth friends at jdecals.com. Always remember, defending our country starts in our very own homes.